welcome back, everyone. Hope everyone's doing all right. Early morning here, so I'm going to try to keep it down a little bit. We're going to take some marshmallow and toppings from Sonora to Portland, Oregon. 5,830 pounds, 694 miles. So let's get this underway. Got the thing set for the map. Before we're gonna stop, we're gonna stop in Hornbrook. Been through there, haven't stopped, so therefore it's not highlighted. Unfortunately, being a vapor, I have to do that outside. I really didn't look at this map to find out where they had me going. Still haven't figured out pulled a blanket over me and no crumb or nothing. So 3:30 this morning, I rolled over and I'm like, oh, my phone's only 75%. I forgot to plug it in. I better plug it in for the last 2 hours before I gotta get up for work. I have work today. Tell you how out of it I was. I haven't been driving since Saturday or Sunday. So I'm kind of out of it. Plus it's early in the morning. So I'm hoping I can get this done before I gotta get the kids up to school. Do a couple of things here in the morning. Come back and do another video, and then I'll have to bed early. Gotta get up for tomorrow. I mean, I kind of like this shift, but... Oops. It definitely seems like I don't get nothing done on that one day off, but it definitely helps on the body. Doctor's appointments for Wednesdays, so that's going to be take away from the video time. But once I get to the point that
go straight on,
I get back on my med schedule, it'll make things a little easier, because it seemed like I was feeling better. Doctor was nothing to do with me being exhausted all the time. You know, because I'm getting 4 hours of sleep a night. I mean, come on. My body's, not designed that way. Yeah, so it's been a hell week for a body. We just, you know, got over that overtime. We're gonna be going back into it just after Thanksgiving. I think it's just after Thanksgiving we start that. Peak. And that'll run all the way until
get ready to turn right. Turn right.
I gotta check the map, yo, because I don't wanna get into someplace I'm not sure where I'm at. Okay, so we're good. Sorry about that. But then it's going to start all over, all the way till hurry the hell up. Come on. You guys can do 65 to 70 through here. I can only do 55 and y'all can't even get around me quick enough. Traffic back for one instead of where I had it for two. And yeah, there's a lot of traffic. I didn't get the other video posted because, like I said last time, I was going to do it and I got home. Sat down for a little bit, had some dinner, washed up. I didn't feel good after I ate, so I laid down, and yeah. 5.5 hours later, I'm up. So good that it kind of crackling and such when I talk. And that's usually if I've got it real close to me, this microphone, you ain't got to have it close. I'd like to get the stand, which isn't a lot of money, but I need to get a different bracket system for my microphone. I want to get a new microphone anyway, but then I can kind of have it come in from the back. Up everything on the right side a little bit because I gotta figure out how I'm gonna set all this up. My space in front of the monitor is getting congested because I went out and bought a little speaker bar because the other speakers I had just were junk. My big THX clicks. THX kind of fucking finally died. So, you know, I had to resort to other measures. And to get the same speakers I had, the Clicks THX. When I bought them, they were $159. They're still $139, so, and that was like 10 years ago, 11 years ago. So they haven't come down much. Right, man. They're really good stuff. turn right because then I wouldn't have to deal with this traffic. That big dog, you're hauling doubles and you can't seem to get out of my way, so.
Keep right and then exit right.
Oh snap.
Exit right.
Ooh, good thing I did pick this. Fuel, I just now noticed it.
Turn left.
Up in here, get some fuel, and rest.
Please, make a U-turn when possible.
Big dog. I like the other ones where you kind of pull straight in and park, not these. I mean, I've been to a lot of truck stops, and normally you don't pull those in. You back in. Take some sleep for the driver. That'll be good. Up there just so I get the end done. The end of the road highlighted. Thank you. off so you can't get past it. Like, believe it or oopsie, yeah, big oopsie. So we'll take this right here. Where's that sign? Put the sign down. This game is kind of, you're gonna have what looks like 2 feet, and it ain't enough. Come on, ain't nobody here. About 7 hours. Never encountered that in real life. I mean, we used to, you know, used to have a CB and be chatting with them all. We'd be banging down the road, and, well, depending on if you have your truck covered or not. I didn't, so we'd be banging down the road at 65 miles an hour. I mean, I don't believe that even, oh, snap. Sorry, big guy. Forgot about the weigh station up here. Oh, boy, everybody's turning in.
Finding a new route.
Turn right. There's like two scales here.
Reroute.
This is some of the redone. Yeah, 46,000 pounds. do like the new fuel stations where you fill up from both sides. Basically, you would do both sides. That's how it is in real life. Oh, this slowpoke is gonna wait forever. It's gonna have to. Oh, jeez, dude. Alrighty then. That I have in as far as the auto mod, the in Oregon, especially Oregon, even during the day you can see a lot of hazy fog, I guess you call it. It's been indicative of real life in the mountains, you know, in winter or autumn, fall, whatever you want to call it. And there's a short stretch where it's only 65, but like I said, I can usually get away with 5 over, so we're going to do 5 over. Nobody on the roads. And truckers could get to and from easily. Kept our distancing and everything and didn't get COVID, and I've been getting tested regularly. definitely think I'm going to like this setup. I just don't know how it's going to pull through the mountains yet, and I won't know until I get, you know, in a mountainous area. Because, like, right now, this thing is just 5.7 miles to the gallon.
Yeah.
Start finding loads to like Yosemite Valley, Lake Tahoe, South Lake Tahoe, whatever it is down there. Start getting some of those filled in Sierra Nevada. Like I said, I'm probably gonna start a new profile and use some map differences to see what might be causing that problem in Reno. I'm still not certain. I thought maybe it was the realistic roads I had in, because I know SCS did a lot with the road network and everything. Making asphalt the way it's supposed to look, not all brand new and, you know, so on and so forth. Like, you can download a mod where the asphalt looks new all the time. That's unrealistic. Oh, there we go. 55. Now, I wonder how that's going to play out. Now I'm 10 over. We'll see. But, roads aren't like that. I mean, there's a lot of new roads where they've redone them, but not like every road that in the game, the mod turns into a brand new road. had it for... By the time the kids get out of school and everything else, if there's any of my young subscribers that watch, we'll be able to see a new video. And then hopefully I can come home Friday night and not pass out like I did last night. Do a new video. Logo for cups and beanies and everything. And I want to be able to do a assortment of colors. And I'm not gonna run gun ho either. You know, I'm gonna do basically what is called a sampler size and see how well I do. If, you know, if I sell a lot of, you know, burnt cells, and we'll continue to go on and create new designs. I mean, I have a couple of designs I'd like to do for you know, different designs for the shirts and stuff. Maybe even, you know, we talked about me and my grandson and my daughter talked about doing possible keychains. Stuff like that, and doing different design logo. Well, keychains would be pretty much the logo of the channel, Cobra Gaming Creations. But like the t-shirts, you know, it's they're all gonna have Cobra Gaming Creations on it, but I might have a different, you know, I have my logo on it, but the back might have a different picture, you know, like maybe put a truck on there, you know, and stuff like that. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to do like a Peterbilt truck. truck and have it say Peterbilt because that's trademarked by Packard.
Keep right,
well,
and then turn right.
They want their money.
Turn right. That's okay. I bet you that purple was going, damn, dude, slow down.
call me like that. Truck wants to run now. Hearing is... the drill for hitting the like and the subscribe button and the bell for notifications for future videos. Ooh, snap.
Turn right.
Yeah. How about the, wait for the metro line, okay? Metro. I've been paying attention. See, this is what I don't like. I'm stuck out on the road. Turn on the strobe so people can see me coming through the parking lot. Why? Because I can. And I like the strobes. I go to view the other YouTubers that play this game, and it's like, I wish you could back it all the way up down to the door. And like, okay, I'm perfectly in line, and yet you can still see spaces on both sides. Alright. We're here. Alright, excellent rating. 699 miles, 19 hours, 1 minute to deliver, 117.2 gallons of fuel consumed for the run. Well, that's going to do it for this video, everybody. Take care of yourself, take care of each other. Until next time, bye!